attack fighter wing is to gain and maintain air superiority. We use the F-15 and employ the full range of ordnance that it carries, the AIM-7 Sparrow, the AIM-9 Sidewinder, and the 20mm Gatling gun, to ensure that there is no other force that can harass our troops on the ground or in the air. The conditions are not too different than we have experienced on the TDY stateside. We have rather old wood frame barracks and a couple of two-story barracks, and they are quite comfortable. All have air conditioning. Some of them have a bath that's shared between two rooms. Others have showers down at the end of the hallway. But relatively speaking, our living accommodations are very comfortable. We have contract catering for our messing facility, and that has progressed and improved steadily since we've been here. The current messing contractor has learned what Westerners liked, and consequently the cuisine is much more appealing to our people now. Our MWR activities have expanded steadily since we've been here. One of the very first things that we did was to gain access to the Saudi gymnasium. That is a tremendous facility, and that includes a 50-meter swimming pool, basketball courts, volleyball courts, bowling alleys, fencing, weightlifting, and so on. Also, we have put up a temporary building in our living compound that is an extension of our MWR facility. We have a TV in there that shows video movies. We have games to be checked out, and our company-grade officers set up a snack bar that serves our population. We've been here 4 months now, and there have been some ups and downs in morale, but I think that it's finally recognized by all the members of the 33rd TAC Fighter Wing that we are here to do a very important job, and when we get that job done, it'll be time to go home. The 33rd has been supported by many other MADSCOMs. In fact, we have representation from Space Command, Strategic Air Command, as well as other bases in Tactical Air Command. Additionally, we have combat communications provided by an Air National Guard unit. That's appropriate that the Nomads be deployed over here to support Operation Desert Shield in Saudi Arabia. Our people recognize that, and they have enthusiastically trained and consequently give us additional capability because they maintain our airplanes so well.
The big difference that we're seeing here is the duration of our missions. We're flying 4+ hour missions here, whereas the normal mission, training mission in the States is about a 1.2 to 1.5 normally max. And considering the additional flying time that we're putting on the aircraft, I think the aircraft are doing a remarkable job. And of course, I give a lot of that credit has to go to the technicians that we have here. They're doing a super job ensuring that the aircraft, when they do have a problem, the fixes are complete and correct. And actually, that's the bottom line to good maintenance, is that you make sure you find the problem and you fix it. the jets 24 hours of the day, we maintain the jets 24 hours of the day. Again, like everything else we do here, with the alert aircraft, it is an across-the-board team effort. Because you've got to have the munitions, you've got to have the aircraft maintained, and you've got to put it all together at one time and make that mission happen. And we are doing that on a day-to-day basis.
The 33rd TAC Fighter Wing is to gain and maintain air superiority. There's no doubt in my mind that we were asked to participate in Operation Desert Shield because of the tremendous capability that we have in the wing, made possible by our people and the F-15C. And that capability means that the F-15C, operated by the pilot that is the best trained in the world and maintained by the best maintainers in the world, can go out and gain and maintain air superiority. In this area, the F-15 with the radar, which we call the Eye of the Eagle, is able to reach out and touch our Iraqi counterpart well beyond visual range. We can do that with the AIM-7 radar-guided Sparrow missile. In a closer environment, we use the AIM-9 Sidewinder to do something similar. And if we have to get in real close, we can use the 20-millimeter Gatling gun that can shoot 100 rounds a second. The capability of the airplane, coupled with the avionics that are on board, makes it the most capable air superiority fighter in the world today. Our pilots know how to operate it and have demonstrated time and time again in realistic training environments that they have no match in the world.
Okay, heads up, 4, watch out so you don't shoot through me. 15 miles. from one.
Option two. Two had to take the Western Man. Western Man.
Check low.
Tally one, nose.
Option three.
Flash one.
Second box from two.
Okay, splash one from one.
Second box from three.
Two, reference north.
Merged.
Two, second splash.
Copy two, reference north.
Splash southern, splash southern.
2-3-4 out. 2-1-0.
Threat east 5.
Bingo, fuel.
5.
Bingo, fuel.
One off your nose, one.
Bingo, fuel. Bingo, fuel.
Okay, is anybody in burners?
No, affirm.
Everybody out of burner.
Reach 6-5 miles.
Four, let's push it up. Pump.
Fox.
Then two, threat, southeast Fox.
It's a good team running southwest, 901.
Three, threat,